Oi, lição número 11, 11A, words, fry, glasses, o óculos ou glasses, os vidros, jug, hungry, cut, lemon, thirst, lunch, heavy lunch, napkin, need, modify. Do you like fried eggs? I like fried eggs. When you are hungry, what do you prefer eating? When you are hungry, what do you prefer eating? When I am hungry, I prefer eating potatoes, lunch, dinner, whatever. And when you are thirsty, what do you prefer to drink? And when you are thirsty, what do you prefer to drink? Eu posso usar what do you prefer to drink or what do you prefer drinking? When I am thirsty, I prefer drinking water. Foi isso que você escreveu? Espero que sim. What do you cut bread with? What do you cut bread with? I cut bread with a knife. Do you drink beer when you are thirsty? Do you drink beer when you are thirsty? No, I don't drink beer when I am thirsty. I drink water. Water. Did you have lunch yesterday? Did you have lunch yesterday? Yes, I had lunch yesterday. The past tense of have is had. I had lunch yesterday. Do you like drinking lemon juice? Do you like drinking lemon juice? Yes, I like drinking lemon juice. What do you need to put your orange juice in when you want to drink? What do you need to put your orange juice in when you want to drink? I need a glass to put my orange juice in when I want to drink. Comparative, superlative, noun, than, alguns pronunciam than, também está correto, than or than. É só não fazer com a confusão com o then do então, né? Adjective, learned, na Inglaterra, learned, nos Estados Unidos, learned, qualify, make, made, very, primeiro, o very, só se usa 99% das vezes, só se usa com outro adjetivo. Ele vai aumentar o próximo adjetivo. Por exemplo, very tall, very high, very beautiful, very much. Então você aumenta o próximo adjetivo. O make, passado é made, e o participio passado é made. Então fica make, made, made. Adjectives are words that modify or qualify a noun. For example, she's a pretty tall young girl. Comparative adjective we use to qualify between two nouns. We add er, for example, Mary is taller than her sister. Superlatives we use to qualify among more than two nouns. We add est, for example, who is the tallest in your family? Os adjetivos comparativos e superlativos. Por exemplo, quando eu tenho a palavra tall, alto, tall, o comparativo entre duas coisas, ou em duas pessoas, no caso, is taller. Who is taller? E quem é o superlativo? É o mais de todos. Quem é o mais alto de todos? Então vai ser o superlativo. Superlativo. Superlativo é para mais de duas pessoas. Duas pessoas, duas coisas. Então, who is the tallest in your family? Tallest in your family. Isso com todos os adjetivos. Então, aqui está o adjetivo, que nós chamamos de adjetivo absoluto. Depois tem o comparativo entre dois e o superlativo entre vários. Entre quer dizer between, e o superlativo é among, entre vários, né? Se você colocar o high, que é para coisas, alto para coisa, você vai colocar higher. Which wall is higher? Tem duas paredes. Which wall is higher? Se tem várias paredes, eu quero saber qual é a mais alta. Which wall is the highest? The highest, a mais alta. The highest. What are adjectives? What are adjectives? Você deve ter lido lá em cima. Adjectives are words that modify or qualify a noun. When do you use comparatives and superlatives? When do you use comparatives and superlatives? We use comparatives to qualify between two names, two nouns, dois substantivos, two nouns. And superlative we use to qualify among more than two. More than two. Mais do que dois. More than two nouns. What's comparative of young? Young, jovem. What's comparative of young? The comparative of young is younger. Tem dois jovens, duas pessoas, eu pergunto, who is younger? Então, um dos dois vai ser younger than the other. Mais novo, mais novo do que o outro. Who is the youngest person in your family? Who is the youngest person in your family? Talvez, maybe, a cousin, a son, a daughter, a nephew. Então, você vai dizer, my nephew is the youngest person in my family. My grandson is the youngest person in my family. Is the lecturer higher than the wall? Is the lecturer higher than the wall? Da nossa classe, nós temos um lecturer, um púlpito, um ledor. E ele é de uma certa altura, vem mais ou menos até a metade, minha metade. Claro que ele é mais alto que a parede. Então a pergunta é, is the lecturer higher than the wall? No, the lecturer isn't higher than the wall. Did you learn how to make some sentences in English? Did you learn how to make some sentences in English? Yes, I learned how to make some sentences in English. Aqui vem um diálogo, né? Primeiro com a Carol. Hey, Paul, how do you like my new shoes? E ele disse, oh, they're pretty. They make you taller. E ela diz, do you think I am short? I am taller than you. Paul, I know it, But you're shorter than my brother. Carol, is your brother much older than I am? Paul, not very much. He's just about your age, but he is the tallest in my family. Carol, is he the oldest too? No, we have an older sister. Carol, I have a sister too, but she is much younger than me. Oh, how old is she? Carol, she's just one. She's just 1 year old. Question, who is taller, Carol or Paul? Lembre que a Carol disse, do you think I'm short? E a Carol que diz, I'm taller than you. Então, who is taller, Carol or Paul? Carol is taller than Paul. Carol is taller. Ela é mais alta. A gente não pode dizer Carol is more tall. More tall está errado. Carol is taller. Porque taller já quer dizer mais alto. Is Paul's brother older than Carol? Is Paul's brother older than Carol? Não, parece que eles têm a mesma idade. Então, não. No. He is just about her age. Ele é quase da mesma idade dela. He is just about her age. Who is the tallest in Paul's family? Who is the tallest in Paul's family? Paul's brother is the tallest in his family. How old is Carol's younger sister? How old is Carol's younger sister? Huh. Carol's younger sister is just one. Okay? See you in the next class. Bye-bye now.